Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalam ala Sayyidil Mursali wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. From today onwards, we are going to start a new series of our lectures on the subject of zakah. Zakah. As you know, there are five pillars of Islam, as the famous hadith says, Buniya al-Islam ala khams. The building of Islam is erected on five things. And the first one is the proclamation, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. There is no authority, there is no other God but one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his last prophet and messenger. Then the second pillar of Islam is salah, the five times prayer. And the third pillar, and the most important after salah, is az-zakah, a financial obligation. A man who has certain amount of wealth, he must pay charity to the poor. And that is called zakah. And the details we shall speak inshallah later on. But it is a charity which is mandatory, which is compulsory, which is an obligation and a command of God. And it is an ibadah. It is considered as an act of worship. This is not only a charity, but it is a kind of ibadah. And so this is a sadaqah. Sadaqah which is given to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the sincerity of heart and intention. That's why it is called sadaqah. But the charity, sadaqah, is a term which is widely used. But when we talk about zakat, it means this is the particular amount of charity and particular kind of charity which is fard or which is wajib, which is an obligation. Whereas the word sadaqah is used for non-obligatory, optional charity also. Zakah is made obligatory in the second Hijri, the second year after migration to Medina. And the famous hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam reported by almost all books is that tukhazu min aghniyaikum wa turaddu ila fuqaraikum. What is zakah? It shall be taken from your rich people and it shall be given to your poor people. So this is the kind of ibadah, financial ibadah. It's a kind of worship in which the money and the wealth is transferred from the rich to the poor. Tukhazu min aghniyaikum wa turaddu ila fuqaraikum. Now, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said many times, وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ, in Surah Al-Muzzammil and Surah Al-Baqarah. And there are many verses of the Quran in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Atu zakah, atu zakah. Pay the charity, pay this charity. And not only that, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told that he must collect zakah from the Muslims. Allah said, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَهِّرُهُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, collect zakah from the Muslim. Khus min amwalihim sadaqa. Tutahhiruhum. It shall purify them. Watuzakihim biha. And with this zakah, they shall be purified. So, zakah, as we said earlier, is from the three Arabic root letters, za, kaf, and waw. And the words which are derived from these three letters, there are so many, tazkiya and zakat and whatnot. All of them have two basic meanings. Number one, growth and development, and number two, purification. So when a rich Muslim pays charity to a poor Muslim, he increases his wealth, he increases himself, he increases his heart, and he purifies his heart, and he purifies his wealth also. It is said in the Quran, in Surah Al-An'am, ayah number 141. Wa atu haqqahu yawma hasadi. And you must pay his right on the day of harvest. You must pay his right on the day of harvest. It means the charity of zakat is an obligation on farmers also, landlords also, on their agricultural produce. And it must be paid immediately on the day of harvest. As Allah said, Yawma Hasadi, Yawma Hasadi. The day it is harvested, on the same day, the zakah of the agricultural produce has to be paid. And the famous hadith we have to remember in Sahih al-Bukhari, hadith number 139, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sending Mu'az ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu towards Yemen. So he said, go and give them a call about accepting Islam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his prophet and messenger. So this is the first thing you have to invite. And then he said, if they accept this, and if they become Muslim, then you should tell them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded to offer salah 5 times a day. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Mu'adh bin Jabal, if they accept the second thing also, if they accept the second thing also, that is 5 times prayer, then you should tell them that Allah has made zakat as an obligation. So this famous hadith reported in Sahih al-Bukhari, the number 139, tells us the priorities of Islam. Priority number one is tawheed and risala, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. Priority number two is aqimus salah, praying 5 times a day. And priority number three is zakah. So this priority has to be understood very clearly. So it means zakat is more important in Islam than Hajj. Zakat is more important in Islam than the fasting of Ramadan. It starts from La ilaha illallah, and then it goes to salah, and then it goes to zakah. And and the famous hadith, Buniyal Islam ala khams, Buniyal Islam ala khams, the building of Islam is built on five things. As you know, affirming that Allah is one and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his messenger, and five times offering prayer, and paying zakah, and fasting in the month of Ramadan, and the last thing is to offer pilgrimage to Mecca at least once in a life. If a man is financially capable to do so. And the scholars of Islam say that there is a consensus, ijma' among all scholars of Islam, that zakat is an obligation, and it is the third pillar of Islam, as it is reported by Dr. Wahaba Az-Zuhaili in his famous book Fiqh al-Islami wa Adillatuhu. So you can understand from this the importance of zakah. And some of the scholars, not some but majority of the scholars, they say, almost all of them, a man who does not believe in zakah, he is not a Muslim. He's not a Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned zakat 32 times in the holy book of Quran, and at least 27 times it comes with salah. أَقِمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ. So salah and zakat come together 27 times in Quran, and we can know the importance of zakah. Now, this pillar of Islam is not a new thing which is prescribed in 625 AD, in the second Hijri, the second year of migration to Medina, but it was an obligation from day one. We shall speak on this subject more, inshallah, in our next episode. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.